The next question is, what is C-flex, or this in within the breath adjustment of pressure? Okay, so what's the idea here? The idea, again, is motivated by the same thing. What can we do to make it more comfortable when you breathe on this machine, which is necessary and which works, but which you don't like? So the thinking went kind of like this. I'm not sure all of this was thought out ahead of time, but looking back at it, I'm cleaning up the thinking a little bit. They said, well, look, again, when the patient breathes out, they're not only not needing the CPAP, but they're breathing out. What makes the air flow is that the pressure goes higher. And where does it collapse? It collapses down here. So if you need 10 to keep it open and you breathe out, how are you going to breathe out against a mask that has 10? You've got to have 11 or 12 or 13 down here to make the air flow. So you actually develop a higher pressure in the airway during breathing out than you need. And so the idea was, well, we can anticipate that and drop the mask pressure so the pressure down here always stays about where it should be, which means that in the mask, we're going to drop it lower when you breathe out. So if you have a prescription of 10, I'm going to give you 10, except when you're breathing out. When you breathe out, I'm going to give you 9 or 8, because I know you're going to add 2 or 3 to it and keep it at 10 in the airway. That's the idea behind C-flex. And it makes perfect sense. And it should work. I don't know if it makes you more comfortable. That's a question that has to be asked. But it feels fairly comfortable when you try it on. So we recently did a study on this. And this slide's working. We'll see what happens on the animation. This is to show you what I was just saying in words. So here's the breath. Here's the flow in. Here's the flow out. And here's the pressure, not in the mask, but down here at the place where it collapses. They're not the same. In the mask, we have one pressure, but in this pressure we have here. The mask pressure stays constant. That's CPAP. The pressure in this supraglottic area dips down. That's what makes the air flow in, a little below CPAP, and then goes up this hump during expiration. And this is perhaps what is uncomfortable. It's clearly unnecessary. So if we could get rid of it, it'd be nice. So what do? Well, if we drop the mask pressure during this period, then we should produce a drop in this, because you put the pressure here, you don't drop it there, okay? Or vice versa, if you take it away here, it doesn't work. So the idea behind it was to do this. Now, the first question is, does it make any difference? And there have been to date now, I think, 4 studies that have compared C-flex with standard CPAP, all other things being held constant. And unfortunately, despite the fact that I think it's a great idea, this is the results. The number of hours that people use with CPAP, the number of hours that people use with C-flex is absolutely no different on average. This is a pretty large study. There are 3 others that are out there. This was in 218 patients after 3 months of use, study done in France predominantly. It should work, but it's hard to show any real difference. And to date, there has been no real data to show that it makes a difference. Patients swear by it, or they don't want it and swear against it, much like the bi-level story, but it's hard to show there's a systematic effect. So my position on that is, it's again, it's one of those things that's a good idea, maybe we can improve on it a little bit, but it's not been shown that it actually achieves its goal. Yes? Again, there's a little incidental research, but again, I'm starting, and most of us are starting from the assumption that you can't do better than CPAP. It's very hard to show any residual problem that has to be cured on CPAP. So how can you do better with anything else? It's certainly possible. The effects are quite small on pressure, but it's a possibility, and there are some studies that have looked at that have begun to. None of them are very big. None of them, to my knowledge, has shown a significant effect. People have looked at blood markers of inflammation. People have looked at sympathetic tone. The effects, if you will, of heart rate would be one of the things like that. I'm not aware of any well-proven data that shows that it benefits one over the other. And again, remember that the main purpose here is not to try and treat residual disease, because there is no residual disease. The main purpose is to get people to feel comfortable enough and want to wear the device longer. That's...
Treating that residual disease, but if it has a negative effect.
Oh, It's conceivable, but I'm not aware of any negative effects in that area. Now, if you drop the pressure too much, you could give under-treatment of CPAP. I mean, certainly if you make the CPAP, Z-flex drop very, very extreme, you could make things worse because you wouldn't be treating people. But remember, the way it's designed, it's supposed to happen only in expiration, and during expiration, it's possible you don't need very much CPAP at all. Okay, so even though we weren't able to show that bi-level was better because it was more comfortable, it's entirely possible you might get something like that. But again, it's been hard to show, all right? And again, I want to emphasize, I'm giving you the state of the art, which tomorrow may be different. This is not a definitive final answer. It's just my way of looking at things is give me a question and I'll try to answer it. Give me a sales pitch and I'll walk away. Okay? So I'm take my pitch the same way. So I'm going to try and prove everything I said. So this is some more data from that same study to show that there really wasn't any demonstrable difference between the two in patients' reported benefit. The question, nevertheless, is out there. There's a lot of patients who say they're better, and I think you have to accept that. So we asked a different question. We said, well, does it in fact do what we think makes things more comfortable? And I'll quickly skim through that to show you. This is, again, a picture of this is our own data I'm going to show you. This is a picture. Here's the tongue. Here's the upper airway. Here's the passageways we're talking about. We made some measurements right here, which is the spot where things collapse, and some pressures in the mask right here, and we asked, this ought to stay, that difference ought to stay the same. So if you drop this, you ought to drop this. But that's an argument, that's not data. So we said, let's measure it and see what actually happens. And I'm gonna cut kind of to the chase and show you the final data. Okay, so here, this is what C-Flex does in the mask. So it accomplishes what it wants to do, which is to say, during expiration, it lowers the mask pressure. It does that. These are each one patient. This is on CPAP, the baseline pressure, and then you can see it's lower in every single patient when you turn on C-Flex. So that ought to do what we said, but that ought to be transmitted down here for you to feel it. If it doesn't get to here, how can you possibly feel it and feel better? All right? And here's what happens down there. So some patients go down, yeah. Some patients go up, some patients don't change. I think it was 15 out of 17 showed no significant change in pressure. So the bottom line is that it doesn't do down here what we thought it ought to. I don't have a good explanation for this. This is a paper we've submitted. I'm pretty sure the data is correct. But whatever it shows is not only does it not have an effect in terms of long-term acceptance by patients, but it also doesn't do quite what we thought, which again teaches us physiologists and doctors humility. Things aren't quite as simple as they seem, and when we actually test them, we sometimes get results we don't expect. All right, so the conclusions were basically that it does what it's supposed to at the mask, it doesn't seem to do what we expected it to at the throat, and thus, if it improves comfort, and that's still an open question, it doesn't do it by that mechanism. There's got to be something else that's making it comfortable. I don't know what that is. One important point, and it will segue me into the next area, is that all of our tests were done while people were sleeping, because that seemed to be the relevant time when they had the apnea. But partly because of this, and partly because of some other data and looking back at this, when we started asking a different question, we said, you know, comfort has to do with what you experience when you're awake. Apnea only happens when you're asleep, and maybe the two are not the same. So maybe I'm not so concerned about what happens when you're asleep, when I'm talking comfort. C-Flex might make you more comfortable when you're awake without making the effect it needs to while you're asleep, and that's not necessarily bad. Okay? It's an interesting perspective that I don't think most of us had until very recently, and it leads me directly into, I apologize, it will lead me directly into something else. Let me talk first a little bit about auto CPAP.